Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own custom emblem logo on a powerful star flare background. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, I'll show you how to create the background and logo design, and in part two, we'll give it color, texture, and dimension. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK. We'll fill it with black. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the fill window. Open the flyout menu and click Black. Then click OK. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Drag the lens flare to the center of the preview panel. Tick 50 to 300 millimeter zoom and reduce its opacity to 50%. Then click OK. Click the lock icon to unlock the background. Enlarge your image by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Click the chain link icon to link the width and the height together. Now, whatever percentage you type into one will appear in the other. In either of the fields, type in 500%. To accept the transform, press Enter or Return twice. Because our background is now 500% bigger, it extends beyond our visible canvas. We want to crop it to just the area that we see. To do this, press Ctrl or Command A to select the area of the canvas and go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To change the color of the lens flare, double-click its thumbnail to open the Layer Style window. Click Color Overlay and change the Blend Mode to Color. Click the color box and pick a color you like. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field 008AFF. Once you pick your color, click OK on both windows. Next, we'll brighten the background and add a scanlines pattern. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with 50% gray. Open your fill window and click 50% gray. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. In the brightness field, type in 20% to pick a very dark gray. Then click OK. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the sketch folder and click Halftone Pattern. Choose Line for the pattern type and make the size 1 and the contrast 50. Then click OK. Change the Blend Mode to Divide and reduce the opacity to 80%. Next, we'll add a soft, dark vignette. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your Elliptical Marquee tool, go to the top left corner of your document, and drag a selection to the lower right corner. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. Then go to the top middle of the transform, and when you see a vertical double arrow, continue to press Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the transform down a little bit. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 100 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with the foreground color, which is black. Then deselect it. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Next, we'll add a bright starburst shape emanating from the center. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Let's name it Starburst. Click the small black and white icon to make your foreground and background colors default to black and white respectively. Then click the curved double arrow icon to invert the colors. Now, white is your foreground color. Open your polygon tool and click Pixels. If you're using version CS5 or earlier, the pixel icon is here. Make the sides 99 and click the gear icon. Check Star, indent the sides by 99%, and check Smooth Indents. We want to create guidelines that show us the center of our document. To do this, go to View and click New Guide Layout. Type in 2 for the numbers of columns and rows and make sure Center Columns is checked. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to the center crosshair and drag out the shape to approximately this size. Change the blend mode to soft light and decrease its opacity to 50%. Let's place all the layers into a folder. Shift-click on the thumbnail of the bottom layer to highlight all the layers and press Ctrl or Command G. Name it Background or BKG for short. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a heavy font. I'm using Great Lakes NF Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make the size temporarily 100 points, sharp, center alignment, and black for the color. Click on your document and type out your text. If you want to resize your text, highlight it and slide the size icon to the left or right. If you want to adjust the space between characters, also known as leading, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. If you have a second line of text and want it to be independent from your first line, click your Move tool and press T to open your Type tool again. Click on your document below your first line and type out your text. Adjust the leading if you need to. Another way to adjust the text's size is to click back on your Move tool and open your Transform tool. For this example, I'd like to make this text match the length of the top line. First, I'll drag it flush with the left edge. Then, I'll go to the lower right corner and press and hold Shift as I drag it out until it's flush with the right edge. To slide your text vertically, press and hold Shift again as you drag it down. Then, press Enter or Return. To resize and reposition your entire block of text, Shift-click on the other text to highlight it as well, and then open your Transform tool. Center it and size it to your liking. Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layers. In this empty layer, we'll place a triangular frame. Open your Polygon tool, and this time choose Shape. In CS5 or earlier, the Shape tool is here. For the fill, click the symbol with the red diagonal line so we won't be filling the shape with any color. For the stroke, click black and make its radius 10 points. We'll give it 3 sides to make the shape triangular. Click the gear icon and uncheck star. Go to the center of the guidelines and drag out your shape. Press and hold Shift as you rotate it until the top point snaps to the vertical guideline. Don't release your cursor yet. To reposition it, press and hold Shift plus the space bar as you drag the shape, then release. To hide the work path, press the Escape key twice. To invert the shape, go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Press V to open your Move tool and drag it to a position that looks good with your text. Use your Transform tool again if you want to resize it. In Part 2, we'll make the emblem come alive. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.